Hello everyone, in this lecture I am going to discuss about the basic terminologies that describes the relationship between the fetus and the mother when the fetus in uterus. So what is the status of fetus in uterus in last trimester of pregnancy, just near term? So that to be indicated by various terminologies. Okay, so if you are going for the antenatal examination, you must know about these basic terms. So yes, I am talking about the lie, presentation, presenting part, denominator, attitude and the position of the fetus. Okay, so let's talk about the lie first here. So lie is the relationship between the long axis of the fetus with the long axis of maternal spine, or you can say the centralized uterus. It means if both the long axis are parallel to each other, then the most common lie is to be formed, which is called as longitudinal lie. Okay, so the long axis of the fetus starts from head to buttock, and the long axis of spine we already know, and the long axis of uterus means from fundal region to the cervical region. So if both the long axis, mother's long axis and the fetal long axis, are parallel or in a vertical line, then this is the longitudinal lie. But suppose if the fetus long axis is slightly tilted in either of the direction, okay, with this long axis of mother's uterus, then if it is tilting 45 degree angle in either of the side, then this lie is to be called as oblique lie. Okay, but suppose if the fetus long axis goes in a horizontal manner with this vertical alignment of the uterus, then this lie is called the transverse lie. Okay, but the most common lies is longitudinal. So the lie could be the longitudinal, oblique and the transverse. So near term, in normal pregnancy, the fetus occupies the longitudinal lie, where the polarity of this fetal axis create a pressure and that will add in easy labor. Okay, now next term is presentation. So presentation is the part of the fetal body part which usually occupies in the lower pole of the uterus. So we know that upper pole is usually formed by the fundal region and the lower pole is formed by the isthmus or the cervical region. So the more bulkier region of the fetus is buttocks. So this buttocks region is usually occupies the large space which lies in the uterine cavity, and it is the fundal region. So in normal, usually the buttocks are lying in the fundal region and the head part usually sinks down and it occupies the lower pole of the uterus. Okay, but the normal presentation is the cephalic. Okay, where the head comes first and it lies in the lower pole of the uterus. So when the head is lying in this region, we are calling as cephalic presentation. But in abnormal cases where the buttocks are lying down, then we can call it as podalic or breech presentation. But suppose if the fetus lies in a transverse manner, then neither the head will come down nor the buttock will come down. So what will be the presentation? That is, the shoulder area is the presentation which occupies the lower pole of the uterus. Okay, so yes, depending on the part of the body of the fetus which sinks down and come in the lower pole of the uterus is called the presentation. So it could be cephalic, it could be breech, or you can say podalic, and maybe the shoulder. But the most common presentation is cephalic, where the head comes down. Okay, next term is the presenting part. So the presenting part is the part of the presentation. Presenting part is the part on presentation which overlies the internal os, and that could be easily felt by examiner when he or she can perform the vaginal examination, that is the PV. So when the examiner is performing PV, by this cervical region he or she can felt that presenting part with the fingers. Okay, so let's talk about the normal. If the head comes down, if the cephalic presentation is there, then what will be the presenting part? There are the three presenting part. It completely depends on the degree of flexion of head. So when head is completely flexed, in that condition the vertex will be the presenting part. Okay, and if the head is slightly extended, it is slightly partially extended, in that condition the brow will be the presenting part. And suppose if the head goes back, that is in complete extension of the head, where the occipital region is just touches the back of the fetus, in this situation the face will be the presenting part. So depending on the degree of flexion of the head, there may be three presenting part on cephalic region, that is normal is vertex, then the brow and the face presenting part. Okay, now next comes the attitude. So what it is? It is the relationship of different body part of the fetus with each other. We know that the shape of the uterus just near term is ovoid. So to occupy this ovoid space, the fetus also become ovoid mass. And how it become ovoid? By flexing its body and bringing all structure together, where you can see that the back of the body is completely convex, the legs are flexed at knees, okay, the thighs are also flexed over the abdomen, okay, limbs are also flexed, okay. So this is how the whole body part forms a ovoid mass that occupies this ovoid space of the uterine cavity. So the normal attitude is complete flexion, where all joints are flexed together, okay. Now next comes the denominator. So denominator is the bony fixed point that is arbitrary, where it is selected randomly, okay. So this is the bony fixed point over the presentation which come in relation with the maternal pelvis, okay. Like we know that the most common presentation is cephalic, and in cephalic the bony fixed point is the occiput. So this occiput come in relation with the different quadrant of maternal pelvis. So you can say that in vertex the denominator is the occiput, but if we are talking about the face presentation, in face the bony fixed point is the mentum or chin, okay. And if we are talking about the brow, in brow the bony fixed point is the frontal eminence, okay. These are the frontal eminence, okay, which are usually comes in relation with the maternal pelvis. And if we talk about in breech the bony fixed point is the sacrum, which comes in relation with the pelvis. And if we talk about the shoulder presentation, there the bony fixed point is the acromion, which come in relation with the mother's pelvis. So it completely depends on the presentation, which part is usually lying in a lower pole of the uterus, and depending on that only the bony fixed point will be come in contact with the maternal pelvis. Yes. Now next come the position. So position is the relationship of this denominator, this bony fixed point, which come in relation with the different quadrant over the maternal pelvis. So we know that on maternal pelvis, on this aspect we can say that there is the right side and there is the left side of maternal pelvis. We already know in bones also we dealt about that, this is the right, this is the left, okay. And along with that, depending on the denominator's position over the maternal pelvis, there are again three division on either side. Suppose if the denominator, if we talk about the normal, the denominator is the occiput in the cephalic presentation, yes. So if this occipital region comes anteriorly on either side of the maternal pelvis, then we can say that is the right and the left occiput anterior, okay. But if it goes back, then we can say that the left and right occiput posterior, okay. And if lies in a horizontal manner, then we can say that the left and right occiput transverse. So depending on the maternal side, there is the right and left one, and along with that, in each 45 degree angle the occiput rotate and forms 8 position on maternal pelvis. So when occiput directed anteriorly, then we can say occiput anterior. If it lies directly posterior, then occiput posterior. But if it goes right and left, anterior posterior or transverse, so depending on that we can say that left occiput anterior, left occiput transverse, left occiput posterior, and same on right side also. So by this you can say that on each 45 degree angle, this denominator forms position over the maternal pelvis and create eight position. Okay, so in this lecture we have discussed the basic terminologies that describes the status of the fetus in uterus. Thank you.